As jy gevra word om al Suid-Afrikase primate op te noem, sal jy 10 teen 1 dadelijk aan bobbejane, blou apies en die twee nagapie spesies dink. Maar het jy geweet dat ons land ook die tuiste van 'n vyfde primaatspesie is?
What's really interesting is that most South Africans don't even know what a Semanga monkey is. They keep asking me, is it a different version of a vervet? And I'm like, no, it's completely different.
Die Semanga-aap hier in Suid-Afrika verskil nie net van hul blou aap neefs nie. Sommige navorsers, soos Kirsten, glo dat van die troepe hier 'n afsonderlike subspesie kan wees van die wat elders in Afrika voorkom, waar hulle as sykes of blue monkeys bekend staan. Sou dit die geval wees, staar die Suid-Afrikaanse Semanga-ape 'n veel groter bedreiging in die gesig as wat mens sou dink. Binne sigafstand is Semanga-ape maklik identifiseerbaar aan hul wolwange, maar as gevolg van hul kleur en grootte word hul dikwels met hul blou apie neefs verwar wat inderwaarheid kleiner is. En terwyl blou apies wyd verspreid in Suid-Afrika voorkom, is daar spesiale vereistes vir die Semangas se habitat.
That's why many people don't know Semanga monkeys because they only occur in these high canopy forests and they do need them.
Hierdie woude kom slegs in die suidelike en oostelike dele van Afrika voor waar dit baie mistig is. In Suid-Afrika is daar nog net enkele sulke woude oor.
Mistbelt forests in South Africa are actually really rare because they need specific conditions to actually thrive.
Die woude bestaan uit plantegroei wat spesifieke diersoorte onderhou. En dis nie net skaars in Suid-Afrika nie. Die woude wat nog oor is, word ook ernstig bedreig.
Mistbelt forest in South Africa currently only makes up less than 1% of the total surface area of South Africa. And then even then it's not one big patch. It's completely divided into less than 100 hectares per patch and some of them very far apart.
Wanneer hierdie lappiebome krimp, word die Semanga-bevolking afgesny. En die natuurlike uitruiling van gene word so verhoed. Op die lange duur kan dit 'n groot impak hê op die uiteindelike oorlewing van die spesie. Kirsten en Bibi bestudeer Semanga-bevolkings in twee heel verskillende streke in Suid-Afrika, maar het onlangs hul kragte saamgesnoer en vir 'n week in Bibi se navorsingsgebied in die Soutpansberge gewerk.
Ja, dit is verwoed. In this area here, which is quite nice, in the western Soutpansberg, it's very undisturbed and the Semangas are living a very natural life here.
Maar verder oos is die reënval hoër en groter landboubedrywighede het 'n invloed op die ekosisteme en dis nie net die Semangas wat bedreig word nie.
Whenever you sit with a situation where a species goes missing, that species played some role in that ecosystem, in that environment. When it's no longer there, there's nothing to fill that role. And the ecosystem is degraded as a result of that.
Die behoud van hierdie laaste stroke misgordelwoude is ook afhanklik van die teenwoordigheid van Semanga-ape.
It has been shown that primates are important to maintaining forest plant diversity just through seed dispersal. For many of the large fruited, large seeded species, Semangas might be the only dispersers. So the ecological role of having these monkeys in the forest is huge, is enormous and not to underestimate actually.
En om suksesvol te kan voortplant, moet die Semangas toegang hê tot 'n uitgebreide genepool.
I'm collecting the fecal samples of the Semanga monkeys because we want to extract DNA and we want to compare this population here in the Soutpansberg in Lejuma to other populations a bit further on to see what's going on and if they're genetically isolated or not. And therefore, I'm hunting poo.
Die monsters lewer sekere data op, maar deur die diere te ondersoek, word daar ook meer oor hul gesondheid en fisiese eienskappe van geleer. Adrian Todef is die veearts van die Nasionale Dieretuin in Pretoria. Hy doen navorsing oor die genetiese diversiteit van die verskillende Semanga-bevolkings in Suid-Afrika en het vir 5 dae saam met Kirsten en Bibi 2 troppe geteiken. Maar aap se kind laat hom nie maklik vang nie.
He won't go in and grab it.
Yeah. Well, they are clever.
Yeah.
Terwyl Kirsten en Bibi meer vanghokke opstel, is daar die onmiskenbare geluid van 'n hok se deur wat toeklap.
Ek dink dis die mannetjie wat ons nou probeer vang het. Hy is redelik groot en hulle is baie sterk.
I usually try and give them enough drugs so that we can work on them for about half an hour. I'm just trying to get hold of his tail. I need to try and stabilize him.
Just grab the end off there.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to eject him. Hold still.
Yeah. Yeah.
Terug by die voertuig word al vinnig gewerk. Monsters en data moet verkry word voor die api wakker word.
No way.
Okay, 10.23.
Yeah.
Sure, but new record.
Wow, that is a record, eh?
It's all those oranges he's eaten this morning.
Hulle het net 'n halfuur. En laastens word die identifikasiemerker aan die api se oor gesit. Die navorsers skryf waardevolle inligting uit elke aap wat gevang word.
We are emptying the cheek pouches now. What they use to actually store, as you can see in this instance, a lot of seeds. It's nice to know which species do they actually store in cheek pouches. And with that get an idea how much they could actually disperse through the cheek pouches.
Tydens die vangoperasie kry die span dit reg om 8 ape onder oë te kry. Hulle wissel in ouderdom en een is selfs dragtig.
Peter's skull is about that size at the moment.
Terwyl dit weke gaan neem voor die DNS en uitslaaf van die bloedmonsters bekend is, sien die span onmiddellik sigbare tekens van goeie gesondheid. Ook dat hierdie Soutpansbergape fisies verskil van die ander troppe wat hulle elders in die land ondersoek het.
These monkeys here in Soutpansberg have almost an entirely black or dark grey sort of tail. The ones in Hoxbeck, we'll see, have a lot of white. Yeah, these also have a lot of gold coloured hair on their back, and is different to the population that we have in Hoxbeck, where they have very little actual gold. It's mainly just a grey back.
Die Semangos wat hier in die ongeriepte Soutpansberge leef, het data van onskatbare waarde opgelever, wat met die van ander troppe in die Ooskaap vergelyk gaan word. Hoxbeck lê hoog in die Amatola berge. Die suidelike hang was in die verlede deur 'n misgordel woud bedek wat in die laaste jare deur denneplantasies vervang is. Kirsten bestudeer die afgelope 3 jaar die impak wat die veranderende habitat op die semangos het. Bolings beskou lyk hierdie na 'n eindelose woud, maar die see van groen is misleidend.
So here we are in a pine plantation. As you can hear, can't actually hear anything. It's so quiet. We have nothing for the monkeys to eat. It's just barren.
Omdat indringerplante baie van die inheemse plante wat se mangoes eet verswalg het, het dit 'n dramatiese impak op die gesondheid van hierdie ape.
Ons het nou gekyk na die ape se tande in Hoxbeck en in die Soutpansberg, en daar's 'n groot verskil. In Hoxbeck het hulle 'n groot impak as gevolg van die uitheemse plante wat hulle eet en harde neute en so aan wat 'n impak het op hulle tande, en hulle tande breek, hulle afslyp, en dan kan hulle later aan glad nie eet nie. Hierdie studie is 'n goeie voorbeeld van hoe die menslike impak 'n effek het op die langtermyn oorlewing van 'n spesies, en hoe selfs die bome en plante wat ons inbring en dink wonderlik lyk, 'n impak kan hê op 'n spesie sonder dat ons eintlik weet wat ons doen. Bring ons hierdie snaakse uitheemse bome in, en hulle het oor die lang termyn 'n groot impak op die natuurlewe in 'n area.
Soos hulle natuurlike voedselbronne verdwyn, word die ape toenemend aangetrek tot die blomme en vrugte in huishoudelike tuine wat hoë energie verskaf, maar die impak daarvan is groter as net swak voeding.
They're just coming into contact with humans and being hit by cars, attacked and killed by dogs, people actually chasing them out with stones, even with paintballs, just trying to get them out because they don't want them eating their crops, their vegetables, and some people are actually scared of them.
Die lot van die Semango ape in Suid-Afrika is 'n toonbeeld van die probleme wat baie van ons natuurlewe vandag in die gesig staar. Maar eers wanneer die uitslaaf van die DNS-toetse bekend is, sal die navorsers weet hoe ernstig die situasie werklik is.
Within South Africa we think we have a particular subspecies of Semango monkey, which if we find certain subspecies from the genetic work that we are doing, then that would have a real impact. Now that subspecies is now threatened itself, And because it would be completely endemic to a particular province, even of South Africa, the numbers would be dramatically reduced and you could have less than 5,000 of a particular subspecies still left in the wild.
Die nuwe inligting kan vir Kirsten, Bibi en Adrian help om die semangos in die misgoddelwoude beter te beskerm.
If it's a completely self-standing subspecies, it would give it a completely different conservation status, completely different importance, because then it influences my management recommendations heavily.
Maar sal dit genoeg wees om die owerhede se aandag te trek en hulle aan te spoor om die semangos en die laaste ongerepte misgoddelwoude in die land beter te beskerm?
It's very difficult for some people to see why a monkey is really important to them in terms of it's surviving or not surviving. But we do know that monkeys play an important role, obviously, in seed dispersal of these tree species. And over a longer distance, that maintains forest integrity. And what we really need to get to is the fact that an unhealthy environment, a degraded environment, ultimately leads to an impact on human health. And what people struggle to see is that link. When you can keep a very healthy baseline, a very healthy ecosystem, then you have to do much less to try and maintain healthy people at the top of the system.